Okay, so currently we are studying clustering. So it is a unsupervised learning problem, right? So the input to our system would be the data points. So if your data points are represented by a two-dimensional feature vector, then we can easily plot them, okay? And if you have a plot, then you can easily see the grouping between those data points, okay? And what we do in clustering, we try to group data points or objects, data points, such that similar points, similar objects are placed in one cluster, okay, and dissimilar in different cluster. Okay, so we try to ensure this two things, different clusters. Okay, then we have seen different approaches . First, the widely popular one is the partitioning technique. So our k-means is the example of this approach. Second one that we are going to study is the hierarchical. Okay, so here we form cluster level by level. Okay, so either you can go bottom up or top down approach. Okay, so here we form cluster in levels. Okay, so examples are agglomerative, then there are density based approach, then we have model based. So we'll be briefly talking about one algorithm from model base, that is Gaussian mixture model, or also known as mixture of Gaussians. Okay, so we have different approaches for clustering. Then we have seen in the yesterday's class how to evaluate the performance of a clustering algorithm. Okay, so clustering performance evaluation. Now, as you don't have true labels, then how to calculate the performance of the clustering? The simplest metric that we have studied is WCSS, that is within cluster similarity score, okay, also known as inertia. And we have seen the definition of WCSS, so just quickly see the definition. So here we calculate a sum of squares of distance of each data point in all the cluster to their respective centroids. Okay, so you consider one cluster, find the centroid, okay, then calculate the distance of each point from the centroid and take the square of that, and the total summation will give you the WCSS score, within cluster sum of squares distance. Okay, so mathematically it can be represented by this. Okay, do for all the cluster, then inside that, for each cluster, for each data point, you calculate the distance of that data point and the centroid and square of that. Summation of everything, summation of all the distances will give you WCSS distance. Okay, then we also talked about the problems with k-means algorithm. The one of the problem with k-means clustering algorithm is how to identify the optimal value of k. Okay, so if you remember the algorithm, our algorithm starts with the k value, right? So how to find that optimal k value? So today we are going to address that issue. So finding optimal value of k for k-means algorithm. okay, and we'll consider one example, okay, and through that it will be clearer, okay, how to identify the k value. Okay, so consider this data distribution. Again, consider every data point is represented by two features, and we have this distribution. Okay, now clearly the optimal value that we expect is k equals to 4, okay, but we don't know that. Okay, so what we can do, we will first find out WCSS score when k equals to 1. Now what do you mean by this WCSS when k equals to 1? Okay, so k equals to 1 means there is a single cluster of this, so you have to form a single cluster of these data points. Okay, now the centroid of that cluster would lie here, around here, right? Okay, so this point, okay, let's represent this point as C1. Okay, C1 means centroid when k equals to 1. Now we know the procedure of WCSS, how to find WCSS. You take a distance of each data point from the C1, square it, okay, and find the value of WCSS. It will be a single value, right? So WCSS will be the highest, right? Okay, so consider you have 20 data points, okay, so calculate those 20 distances, okay, this distance, then this distance, and square of that. So WCSS will be highest in this case. And let's say we have 200 unit score. Okay, so far so good. Okay, so we have calculated WCSS score when k equals to 1. Then WCSS when k equals to 2. Now k equals to 2 means you have to form two clusters. So the nearest clusters, so we may get this first cluster and this as the second cluster. So you can find out the centroid of these two clusters. So this is my C2 and this will be my C2. Then repeat the same process. Now WCSS value will be lowered, right? Okay, so there will be decrease in WCSS because see, the cluster is more closer to the data points now, right? Okay, so you will get a decrease in WCSS score, and it will be somewhat higher, and let's consider it is 100 units score. Okay, in lab session we will be calculating the actual scores of WCSS. Okay, so it will be smaller than this original score because the centroid is now closer to the data points, right? Then WCSS when k equals to 3. Now you have to form three clusters. Okay, so this cluster is much farther, right? Okay, so consider this is forming one cluster. Okay, and consider this cluster has splitted into two. Okay, so now you have this bigger cluster, this cluster, and this one. Again, you find out the WCSS. So the centroid, the C3 will be here, okay, here, and C2 will remain. Okay, now this will become C3. Okay, now WCSS score will be lowered now, right? Okay, because this cluster is splitted into two, right? Now each individual cluster is having its own centroid and which is much closer to the data points, right? So again there will be a decrease in WCSS score. It will be somewhat high, and consider it is 75 units now. Continuing the same process, when k equals to 4, WCSS equals to, now k equals to 4 form 4 clusters. I can get this clusters now. Okay, this one, cluster 2, cluster 3 and cluster 4. Find the centroid, so it will be at the center of this clusters. Find out the WCSS. Now it will be smaller, okay, and consider it is 25 or let's say 35 units, somewhat half of that. Okay, then WCSS when k equals to 5. Now observe the trend. Let me plot this course up to k equals to 4. So I can plot k on the x axis and WCSS on y axis. So my k, initially it was 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. What can be the highest value for k? Can anybody tell me? What should be? Do we have upper limit for k value? Anyone? Can we place a upper bound for k value?
There can, as many number of clusters can be formed, so how can we have upper bound?
Okay, so you are saying that we cannot set upper bound. Any other answer?
We can set, but then according to data, any number of clusters can be formed.
Okay, so you are saying it will be hard to find the upper bound for k. Any other answer?
Sir, number of data points.
Yes, exactly. Okay, how many clusters you can get? You can get, okay, so if data points are 10, then you can at max get 10 clusters. Then you can't, means can you have 11 clusters for 10 no. data points? No. Okay, that means you will be having a fraction of data point in two clusters, right? Okay, so the maximum value of k would be k equals to n. N is the number of samples. Okay, so that will be upper bound. Good. Okay, so you can have a single cluster, okay, all the data points in a single cluster, or each data point will be one cluster itself. Okay, good. So we have the pattern here. So let's say 200, 100, 100. So when k equals to 1, okay, roughly we are getting WCSS equals to 200. Okay, these are rough figures only. Okay, 200, 100, 75 and so on. Okay, then when k equals to 2, the score is 100. K equals to 3, it was around 75, then 35. Now you tell me, so we have steady decrease in the WCSS value as K is increasing. Now henceforth, what is the expected pattern of WCSS? Can you tell me? Can we have an increase in K value, WCSS value? What is the meaning of WCSS? It is the summation of distance of data points from the centroid, right? So see what will happen. K equals to 5. Now out of this 4 cluster will be splitted in 2. Okay, consider, so I think the variance is more for this cluster. Okay, so now it will be splitted in 2. So consider you are having this cluster and this cluster. That one cluster will be splitted in 2. Okay, this will not change, right? These clusters will not change. Now their centroid will again come closer to the data points, okay, but that decrease will be less, okay. So you may get WCSS value as 30 units, then WCSS when k equals to 6, WCSS equals to, so I think we have consider this is splitted into, and we have this clusters, okay. Again there will be somewhat decrease in WCSS, but that will not be that much significant, okay. And if you plot like this, if you continue, this graph will never go up, okay. WCSS will keep on decreasing and so on. And if you see, if you connect the dots, so you will get a pivotal point, okay, you will get a pivotal point where you have, okay, after which you get a line which is very much parallel to the x-axis, that you have to treat as the k value, okay. So as these are rough figures, okay, it should be much closer to x-axis, and this graph looks like elbow, okay, it looks like elbow, this, that's why this method is known as the elbow method. So the method is very easy, okay. So you have to write one loop which will vary from, so for I in range of n, okay, n is the data sample, okay, starting from 1, okay, starting from 1 comma n plus 1, then you find out the WCSS score. So you have inbuilt function for calculating the inertia score. So you calculate the WCSS, you plot the values, and that pivotal point where you have the highest decrease in the WCSS value will be treated as the optimal value of k. Okay? And another test is, after that k value, the line you will get will be somewhat parallel to the x-axis, okay. So you can treat that k value as the optimal one, okay. Did you get the concept how to find the optimal k value? So if you don't have idea about how many classes are there, then you can follow this technique, okay. So you write a loop going from k equals to 1 to n, okay, find out the WCSS score, plot it, or you can write some logic for finding that the highest decrease in the value, okay, and you take that value as the k value, okay. Got the idea? Any doubt? So here we'll finish the k-means algorithm, okay. So k-means is over. Tomorrow we'll see the implementation of k-means algorithm. Now we'll start with hierarchical clustering, second category of clustering known as hierarchical clustering. Now in hierarchical clustering, so clusters are formed in levels, okay. So now hierarchical means what? So you will have a levels, okay. So either you can go bottom up manner or top down manner, okay. So based on that you have two types. The first one is known as the agglomerative clustering, and it follows bottom up approach. Okay, bottom up means what? So I can denote the data points as the leaf of the node. Okay, so consider I have 5 data points and each data point will be treated as one cluster. Okay, now based on the distance metric or the given criteria, you start grouping the data points. Okay, so consider A and B are the closest, so I will group them and form a new cluster. Consider D and E are having this much distance. Okay, so this diagram is scale diagram. Okay, so this means the distance between A and B is less as compared to D and E. Okay, it is drawn up to the scale. Okay, and consider then you have this much distance, okay, between C and this cluster. Okay, D and E are clustered together, right? Then you have this much distance between C and this cluster. Then you may group these two clusters, and as you have single cluster now, okay, that will be your termination criteria. Okay, so it follows bottom up approach. Then second point is, initially the algorithm is very easy. Initially each item then okay initially each item will be a cluster itself. Then what you are doing, you are grouping, right? So iteratively until all objects are merged, all objects are merged into a single cluster. Okay, and suppose if you are interested in finding 3 clusters out of this data point, so what you will do? So I will find that particular distance, threshold distance value, okay, and that will be my decision boundary. So I will cut that dendrogram. This tree like structure is known as dendrogram. Okay, this tree like structure is known as dendrogram. Okay, and I will find that particular threshold value and I will cut this dendrogram. Now you can get 3 clusters. One cluster containing A and B, second cluster containing C only, third cluster containing D and E. Okay, if you are interested in 2 cluster, cut the dendrogram here. You get 2 cluster containing A and B in one cluster, C, D, E in another cluster. Okay, so this is following bottom up approach. And let us write about dendrogram. Dendrogram is a tree like structure. So it is a tree data structure and it is used to represent hierarchical clustering data structure, which illustrates hierarchical clustering technique. Okay, and it is drawn to the scale. Okay, so this represents, okay, so it is drawn to the scale. So A, it represents the distance between A and B is less as compared to D and E. Okay, so you can draw this on the graph paper, drawn to the scale, then leaf node. So on leaf node you have individual cluster, okay, on the leaf node of dendrogram you have the individual cluster or data points, and at the root level you have a single cluster. Okay, so this data structure is known as the dendrogram. So this is first approach, bottom up approach. Okay, you start with each data point, okay, and consider each data point as the cluster. Then you start merging. Okay, so consider any criteria. Okay, so you can consider the distance formula, okay, and start grouping and repeat this process till you get a single cluster. Then second one is known as divisive approach. So it will be a reverse process of agglomerative. So here it is a top down approach. Okay, you start with all data points as a single cluster. Okay, and then you start splitting large clusters are then successively divided. Okay, so if I want to represent these two approaches, so if you are going bottom up, so that will be agglomerative type of clustering, and this will be divisive. Okay, so let us solve one problem. So while grouping or splitting, we have to consider the distance between the cluster. So if you have these two clusters, so we have discussed this in previous class, but a quick revision. Okay, so between the cluster, so that is known as inter cluster distance. So you have different combinations possible. So you can go for the minimum distance between the data points, minimum possible distance possible. Okay, so that is known as the single linkage. Okay, and its formula would be minimum DC1 and DC2. Okay, so this is a data point from the C1 and data point from the C2. Okay, so minimum distance possible will be known as single linkage. Then you have complete linkage. It would be a maximum possible. So I think maximum is for these two data points. Okay, so maximum between DC1 and DC2. Then you have the average linkage. Okay, so this is a brute force approach. You find the distance of every possible combination. Okay, so take the distance of this point from each of this, then for this, okay, and then take the average of that. So it is a group average. And the last one is the centroid linkage. Okay, so this is the distance between the centroids. So find the centroid. Okay, so distance between the centroid. So we represent centroid by either by mu or m1, right? So m of c1, m of c2. Okay, so all right, we'll solve one problem which was asked in previous DBAR2 paper. Okay, So we have that day we have solved this problem. Okay, it was based on k-means clustering. Now this problem is based on hierarchical clustering. Okay, no specific algorithm is mentioned. Okay, so either you can apply the agglomerative or divisive. Consider following distance matrix. So the distances between the points is given in the form of a distance matrix, and apply the hierarchical clustering to cluster the objects u, v, w, x, y. 5 data objects are given. Okay, so at max you can have 5 clusters, minimum 1 or maximum 5. Okay, and they have not asked for the dendrogram, but the sub question for this problem can be also plot the dendrogram of the hierarchical clustering, that clusters you got. Okay, so many times dendrogram will be asked. Okay, so we'll be plotting the dendrogram for this data distribution. Now observe the things which are given here. Now along the diagonal axis you have zeros, so that means the distance between the points itself will be zero, right? Distance of u from u will be zero. Okay, then it is a scalar quantity, that means you have the its transpose will be same, right? Consider this is my D matrix, and the transpose of D will be same. Okay, see, you have 1 here, 1, then 2, then 2, then 3. That represents D distance of A comma B equals to distance of B comma A. Okay, so actually you can ignore the upper values. Okay, so let us solve this problem. We are going to apply agglomerative, so we have to write that assumption. Okay, so assume, okay, and we have to again assume about the distance that you are going to use. Okay, here explicitly they have not mentioned which distance metric to be used. Okay, because we have to merge the distances, merge the clusters, right? So which distance metric to be used? Okay, I can show you the problems where this will be mentioned. Just a minute. See here, for the given data point, construct a dendrogram using complete linkage method. Complete linkage means you have to take a maximum distance, right? Okay, so it will be explicitly mentioned. Now in our problem, they have not specified anything. Okay, so we have to assume. Okay, so we'll be going with the single linkage, and in next lecture we'll be solving a problem based on the complete linkage. Okay, so assume agglomerative algorithm is applied with single linkage distance. Okay, so we will be using single linkage and agglomerative algorithm. Okay, so let us solve this problem. So you have data points u, v, w, x, y, 0, 1, 2, 2, 3, 2, 4, 3, 1, 5 and 3. Okay, so you can actually ignore the upper triangular matrix, but I will be using now start grouping the data points. Okay, so just ignore the upper triangular matrix, and in the bottom, okay, so these numbers are the distances between the data points, right? Okay, so we'll be following we will be using the distance criteria. Now start grouping the data points based on the distances between them. So you have the least distance for u and v and x and w. Okay, ignore the diagonal elements also. Okay, so in this, so the least distance is 1, right? It is for v and u and x and w. Okay, so we'll go top to bottom. Okay, so you consider this one. Okay, so we can pair u and v, start grouping the data objects. So at this stage, each data point is a cluster itself. Okay, now you start pairing. So pair u and v, and the distance is 1. Okay, now we have paired u and v, so that will be treated as one cluster now, represented in this round brackets, u, v, w, x, y, w, x, y. Okay, now fill the table. So along the diagonal you will have the zeros. Okay, don't calculate the upper triangular matrix, it will be a mirror image of this. Okay, now do we have change in distance between x and w? No, right? We have not touched them, so you can directly write the distance between x and w. X and w is 1. Y and w 5, and y and x 3. Okay, but we have to calculate these three distances. Okay, now for that we have assumed that we have to use single linkage. Okay, so how to find distance of u and v, distance of u and v from w? Okay, so we know the formula. So it will be a minimum distance of, okay, take the possible combination, minimum distance between u w and v w. Okay, so what you have done, so these were the five data points. Okay, you have clubbed this two. Now you are willing to club this and this. Okay, so you have to find the minimum distance, right? You are using single linkage, so you find the distance of this data point from this cluster, and as it is single linkage, take the minimum of possible distances. These are the possible distances, take the minimum of that. Okay, so exactly that is we are finding. So uw, the distance of uw is 2, minimum of 2. Vw, v and w is 2, so minimum of that is 2. Similarly, distance of uv, w ho gaya, ye 2 ho gaya, theek hai. Okay, and x, minimum of distance between u x, distance v x. U x is 2, v x is 4, is 2, so 2. Then distance of u v from y, minimum distance u comma y, distance v comma y. U y is 3, v y is 3, so minimum of 3 comma 3. U y is 3 and v y is 3, so it will be 3, and this value will be 3. Okay, so same you can replicate in the upper triangular matrix, 2 2 3 2 2 3, 1 5 and 3. Okay, done. Next, so this is my iteration number 1 is over, right? Okay, we have grouped two data points. Now you have to consider this matrix, ignore the upper triangular matrix. So you have this 6 distances, the least distance is 1. Okay, so circle that, and it is a distance of x and w. So let us group them. So we are grouping or pairing x and w, and the distance is 1. So you have already grouped U and V, treat it as one cluster, then X and W, okay, X and W as one unit, X and W as one unit, and Y is remaining. Okay, so X and W and Y, okay, the diagonal element would be 0, right? Now the distance between U, V, okay, distance between U, V and Y, okay, there is no change, right? U, V, Y, we have the value, so U, V, Y is 3, okay? Now you have to calculate these distances, okay? So distance between X, W and U, V, okay, this cell, okay, it would be minimum of distances, find out every possible combination, okay, X U D X V W U and W V, okay, so find out the values. X U is 2, X V is 4, WU is 2, WV is 2. Okay, so this is the two value. This the value for this cell is 2. Then distance between XW and Y, it would be minimum of every possible combination. So XY and distance between W, Y. Okay, XY is 3, minimum of 3, WY is 5, 3. Okay, so this value is 3. Okay, and same I can replicate here. The next value, the least value, is this one. Okay, I can group now UV XW. Okay, so pair UV XW, the distance is 2. Okay, so I will have UV XW, okay, and okay, each, this is individual cluster, right? Okay, then Y, U, V, X, W and Y. Okay, now it is simple matrix, 2x2 size. We know the diagonal element would be 0. We have to calculate a single value. Okay, so the distance of bigger cluster U, V, then X, W and Y will be minimum of, okay, so U, V or Y ka distance kitna hai, U, V or Y ka distance hai 3, X, W or Y ka distance kya hai, X, W or Y का डिस्टेंस 3, ओके, सो दिस विल बी 3, ओके, सो दिस सेल वैल्यू इज 3, डन. सो फाइनली यू हैव टू क्लब दिस, ओके, एंड दैट क्लबिंग दैट क्लस्टर डिस्टेंस वुड बी 3, ओके, बिकॉज यू हैव सिंगल वैल्यू, ओके. नाउ द डेंड्रोग्राम फॉर above clustering is, okay, so now we know that it is drawn to the scale, right? Okay, so along the x-axis you will have data points, okay, and maximum distance is 3 only, right? So 1 2, 3. Okay, so you have UV. Okay, their distance was, they were pair for distance 1, right? So uska this line will be of 1 unit. Then next pairing happened for x and w at distance equals to 1. Okay, so plus them. Okay, but in advance you see which two data points are clubbed then. Okay, we club these two cluster. Okay, so we'll draw them side by side, x w. Okay, distance was same 1. Then these two were clubbed, okay, on distance 2. Okay, these two are clubbed at distance 2. And finally, we have clubbed this cluster, okay, this cluster with y at distance equals to 3. Okay, that's it. Done. And if you want to find 3 cluster, okay, then your threshold value should cross 3 lines. Okay, so cut it here, you get 3 cluster, UV, XW and Y. Okay, so this problem will be the easiest that you can get, right? Nothing to remember. Any doubt, shall I repeat?
No, sir.